What's up, you amateurs? Sussel Podcast Season 3, Episode 5, back in the pod booth, back here on my lonesome. And lots to get through. We had Challenge and Reserve Cup action over the weekend. I so fortuitously had the bye. Sterling had the bye. So it's good to come into the booth, not coming off a loss. The energy levels are high. My faith in the world is, although fleeting, it's still there. So that's good. We also have one Sunday Premier Division game from Elizabeth Downs and Unley United Amateurs. And if you haven't seen the results, we'll get into that. And we have a goal from the main man, Josh Farrell, in our Pegasports Goal of the Week segment. Not much footy happened over the weekend, so the remainder of the Pega Goal of the Week segment will be done by us as a team, as a squad, as a unit, looking at some highlights provided by Matt Pilt. How many times have we said that? Dozens, I'm sure. So we'll get through the results, we'll get through Pegasports Goal of the Week, and then amateurs, as we like to end, we will be looking at an interview from around the grounds, namely the Southern Breakers versus Angle Valley Division 3 game over the weekend. Cup game. It's going to be good. It's going to be bloody good, amateurs. Let's get into it. See that bloody arrow from the levy? Far out. Nearly got me. Amateurs, as our beloved Elizabeth Downs were in some good, honest Australian Cup action, flying the Sassel flag oh so high, they were required to play a catch-up game this weekend against Unley United. Unley, listen, tough start to the year, amateurs. It's been well documented, but the only way is up, and I can empathize with a side that's not had the best start to the year. So, you know, Unley, you can say the same about last season as well, but you pulled it back. But yeah, that process didn't quite kickstart this weekend because Elizabeth Downs were 5-1 victors. Let's have a little digsy here, amateurs. Where did the goals come from? Thomas Blackett, God, look at him. No, that's Matt Holliday. Thomas Blackett looking, his smile could cut down a village. What a king. Freshly moved out to Wosley's as well. Life is good, man. Life is good. Okay, over-embellishing once again. Joshua Farrell scored a brace, 34th and 39th minute. We'll get into that a little bit later. Braden Gundlach, Sassel royalty, if you don't mind me saying. He scored in the 25th. Nathan Bloody Day scored another header, and that might just be my new favorite brand of goal, a Nathan Day header. He scored in the 88th, amateurs, and then Ben McMullen in the 82nd, Dylan Costanzo with three of the best minutes, I heard. So shout out to the Downs doing it once again. Who scored for the mighty, mighty Unley? Who scored? It was Zico Yahei Osaki in the 55th minute. And we will have a look at one of Josh Farrell's just simply stunning goals later on in the episodia. Let's see what else was crack-a-lack. And we start with a Sunday versus Saturday Challenge Cup match. And boy, oh boy, was it a tough day out for the fine folks over there at Adelaide Uni. Interesting lineup from Uni, a few unfamiliar faces there. But it was Southern Knights who did the job. Dylan Tor with a hat-trick, David Thornton in the 37th, and Matthew Daughtry in the 87th. We got two Daughtrys playing. That's emotional. So Sunday prevailed in that one. And then it was Croydon Cougars 6-2 over SBS. Joseph Tassione helped himself to another two. Saved some goals for the rest of us, mate. Zach Zoyner, what a jet. He scored two. Gareth Pearce scored one. And Daniel Bendo in the 94th. Man, it was all happening. It was all bloody happening. Who scored for SBS? We had Harmanjot Singh. And not sure. Not bloody sure, amateurs, but that's the beautiful thing about the Sassel podcast. That's okay, you know? You don't have to be sure. We have a 3-0 forfeit going the way of Garn. Adelaide Dragons Sporting Club must have had something else on. Something more important than a Challenge Cup game. Doubt it. Another forfeit from MA Hawks this time. Interesting. Very interesting. West Beach coming out 3-0 victors there. Win's a win, baby. Mono Para 5-0 over Roe Park. I believe those highlights amateurs can be found on our Facebook page. Matt Pill didn't want the week off. Didn't want the opportunity to trim the lawn and clean out the kitchen, much to the dismay of Mrs. Matchday Productions. But nonetheless, he was out there doing what he does best. Filming local footy. And the goals came from for Mono Para, the pride of the North, as their badge says. Adam Harding with a hat trick. Matthew Hickman and Shane Winter, the El Capitano. Tough day out for Roe Park. Who've they got going on over there? Couple of shooters, man. Couple of heavy hitters. What else we got going on? Maiwand Football Club in the Challenge Cup were 3-1 victors over the Cove. Can we see who the goals are? Yes. Mohamed Ghafouri, Mohamed Elzobir, and Mushtaba Hazara. Eloquent names. Beautiful off the tongue. 3-1 for Maiwand Football Club. And we'll look at the Cove goal scorer. It was Andre Papp. So shout out to the Cove. Bigger and better next year, I'm sure. And then AC Unido go from strength to strength. George and Carlo have the boys absolutely humming. They came up against their fellow Division 3 rival. Great badge from Salisbury Villa, by the way. This is an interesting one, amateurs. Not one I would have picked personally, but then again, my football knowledge is lacking. We've seen that before. We'll see it again. Salvatore Romano, that looks like a hat trick to me. Yeah, it looks like there's three balls there. It's not confusing at all. David Nachiyunde, he scored the other two. Carlo on the bench in GK. Let's have a look at this photo. Wowee. I'm sure we don't have the strongest female contingent on our podcast, amateurs, but if there is, you enjoy that because, wow, what a handsome, handsome young man. We move forward and we move to the Sunday Premier Bees. They also had a catch-up game and it was once again Elizabeth Downs overcoming Unley. Goal scorers were as follows. For the Downs, we had Bonaventure Iracozzi. Stellar name, simply. And then Braden Holdcroft in the 96th and a yellow 7 minutes before that after coming on in the 81st. That's what you like to see from your subs. Get in there, get in amongst it, get it done. That's the Downs we know and love, amateurs. That's the Downs we know and love. Southern Knights doing the cup double rather, over Adelaide Uni. 4-2 victors in the B grade. Jacob Ross Masters, Samuel Zeno Egger, Justin Moulet. I like Moulet. Justin Moulet. Lockie Maguire. Lockie with an O. That's strong. Says he's a goalkeeper, but it says he scored, so that's interesting. I like that. Good on him. And then Jensen Childs, another great name. Sounds like a bit of a Formula 3 type operator. 5th and 80th minute for Jensen. Next game, amateurs. SBS Reserves versus Croydon Reserves. And it was SBS who got their side up and about. Harjot Singh Badwal, 43rd minute. And Manveer Kumar in the 37th. And it was Nicholas Stafridis for the Croydon Cougars. Shout out to SBS. Hopefully they can go all the way. Hopefully. Challenge and Reserve Cup. Reserve Cup. Garn 5-1 victors over Macedonia United. So the reserves showed up. Good to see. And the goal scorers for Garn in their 5-1 victory were Pablo Fagundes, 25th and 86th. Zabiula Fakri, he scored in the 14th and 66th. And Zulfikar Husseini, 39th. And for Macedonia, Jacob Kamis, he scored. Yeah. Next game, amateurs, another forfeit to the MA Hawks. Tough day out for the Hawks. Bigger and better next week. Roe Park, they lost 4-1 in the reserves to Mono Para. Mono Para reserve goal scorers, Nash, Linden, Daniel Penn, and a brace off the bench for Mark Brooker. You absolute ripper for Mark. off the bench. Start him next week, coach. Start him next week. That's what they're saying. Next game. Cove. Reserves. 3-2 winners over Maiwand. Showing the A grade how it's done, amateurs. That's what we like doing. That's what we're all about. Luke McMaster helped himself to a goal. Jonathan Hunter, both centre backs. Perhaps a set piece merchant side. Not too sure. Ben Willis off the bench with a goal as well. And for Maiwand, the two goals came from Mohamed Rahimi. And perhaps an own goal. Yes, Cooper McCabe off the bench, own goal. Nonetheless, it was the Cove who got the chocolates. AC Unido doing the double over Salisbury Villa. They were 4-2 winners in the reserves. Goals came from... can't see him, but that's okay. The result's all that matters. The result's all that matters, amateurs, especially in the cup. I don't need to tell you that twice, do I? That's results, amateurs. Let's get into... the Pega Sports Goal of the Week, baby.
Pega Sports Goal of the Week.
Now, amateurs, I like to look after the podcast fans, and boy, oh boy, do I like to look after podcast royalty. And Josh Farrell meets those requirements. He's, you know, I don't need to say it. He's, you know, he's dominated the headlines for years now. But he's once again in contention for Pega Sports Goal of the Week. And that, when you solve one problem, you create another. And I think if we were to take a cursory eye over Josh Farrell's bedroom and we were to look at his sock drawer, at his Pega Sports grip sock drawer, it would be overflowing at this point. It would be disastrous. It would be shaking the very foundations of his house. And we don't want to do that. We don't want to cause structural issues at Podcast Royalty's homes. So what we're going to do is we're going to build him a shed out the back. And he can start storing these beautiful, well-made, slick-designed Pega Sports grip socks, man. Let me just take a look at them. Sometimes you just need to do the research yourself. Oh, man. Stick to my face to that grip.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
All right. Killing a bit of time with that one, amateurs. Anyway, let's get into it. Josh Farrell against Unley United. Here he is taking a corner. Great footage. Who's going to get their head on this one? Oh, dearie, dearie, dear. The swaz. The impotence. The cheek from Josh Farrell. Love that guy. Great start to our Pega Sports Goal of the Week segment. It's such a pleasure to have Josh Farrell back in to the fray. You know what? That's fine. That's good. That's fine. All right. The remainder, amateurs, of our Pega Sports Goal of the Week segment will be us, you, me, looking through the highlights from Southern Breakers versus Anglevale Cup game. Looking forward to this one. And we're going to pick a goal from that game. So let's go through it together. Let's talk over the top. Let's commentate. And yeah, let's get into it, man. Beautiful day down there at Port Elliot. Sun shining, bit of sea breeze. Sure the Anglevale lads made use of that unbelievable bakery. Orange kits, good to see. Oh, ref, please. Don't argue, mate. It's a pen every day of the week. Oh, he's laughing. We'll see just who's laughing here. And it's Southern Breakers. No, it's not. A poor penalty. Anglevale with a bit of fight back here. Out to the number 7. Great crowd down there. Div 3 side, and they got a crowd like that. It's better than some Prem clubs. Great football from the Breakers here. A great pass. A great finish. Landon Beaton. A great team goal. That's definitely in contention. Number 14 in the tucked in kit. Absolutely love that. Footy. Oh. Oh. Tucked in. Finish. I would have given it right then and there. Number 14, you're my new favourite Southern Breakers midfielder. Competition's not great so far, but we're still early in the video, Mark. Great clearance. Great hustle from the Southern Breakers. Repelling attacks. Good ball. Good ball. Good hit.
Unlucky.
Anglevale with a sustained period of pressure here. Can they capitalise? No, they cannot. I would love to know the logistics of if Anglevale were to go all the way in the cup and came up against the Sunday version of Anglevale. Oh, he's hit the crossbar. He's hit the crossbar. Yeah, I'd love to know the logistics of that. Defensive header. 14, here he is. Give it to me. Ref! Please! Oh, it's outside the box. Please, 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 please. Yes! Joel Harris, now I have a name to put to that beautiful face, to put to that beautiful tucked-in kit. Joel Harris, you're in serious danger of having to clear some space in your sock drawer, my friend. 2-0 to the Breakers. Oh, he's bloody everywhere. Oh, he's given it. Definite penalty.
Shit.
Everywhere was old Jolly Harris. And that's a great pen from Jordan Sakharin. What would happen if I gave a penalty to the Pegasus Sports Goal of the Week? Joel Harris, my man of the match. How long we got? Not long. Definite penalty, by the way. Here we go. Gareth Bale. Oh! Oh! Okay. Well, my boy Harris might be in some trouble. Jake Costa, ladies and gentlemen. Dearie dear, how the turntables. Full time, Southern Breakers. Through to the next round, amateurs. What a day down there. And my gosh, what a long trip for Anglevale. We're a research-based podcast, amateurs. Let's see how far it is from Anglevale to Port Elliot. 1 hour and 45 minutes for a 3-1 loss. Now, if that's not character building, I don't know what it is, man. All right. Pegasus Sports Goal of the Week. My three contenders are Josh Farrell with a corner goal against Unley United. I think the quality of the footage might do him a little bit dirty there. It looked like there was A, either a bushfire adjacent the pitch, or B, it was filmed in 1942. That's going to hurt him. My boy Joel Harris with the tucked-in kit. Very nice goal. I might have taken a deflection. I might be letting my own personal love for people wearing tucked-in kits cloud my vision. If I was to be non-biased, which I always am, it would have to go to Jake Costa. And it does. Jake Costa, Anglevale, Division 3A in the cup. You didn't get the chocolates, mate, but you got something even better than that. You got yourself a pair of Peg Grip socks. That camera is about 3.5 meters away. We're going to go for it. All right. There's a big light here. I've hit that. Yeah. But nonetheless, that doesn't affect you, Jake Costa. You have a pair of Pega Grippies coming your way, my friend. Please email Pega. Please email info@pegasports.com.au, size, color, star sign, and Costa will sort you out. All right, amateurs, that was very enjoyable. You know, the matches of the rounds this year are evidently in a slightly different format to previous years, but I think it's a great opportunity to give some other clubs in some other leagues in some other parts of our great state, as was seen there, some exposure, some engagement, and you know what? Some love. And I loved what I saw from the Southern Breakers, and I loved what I saw from Jake Costa of Anglevale. Shout out to both clubs. And now, instead of me ineptly and incompetently and just, instead of me talking about these two great clubs, how about we hear it from the horse's mouth themselves? We have two men from both clubs, filmed by Matt Peel in our pre-game interviews from Southern Breakers and Anglevale. Let's get their insights. Let's see what it's all about. Cheers.
Now I'm with Josh Peters, first team coach for the Southern Breakers. Josh, thanks for joining me this afternoon. And what's the mood like around the place today?
Oh, really good. Really excited. Beautiful weather. I think it's going to be a good game.
Yeah, absolutely. And can you tell us a little bit about the history of the Breakers, what year they were founded? And do you have a little fun fact for us as well?
Oh, look, I could probably think of a fun fact, but the club started in 98. And it was at Victor Harbour High School, I think, when the first game was in 98. And then it moved to the Port Elliot Showgrounds before the footy here folded, or not a folded, they amalgamated with Goolwa. And so then we took this ground over, which is our home, and we've been here for over 20 years, and great spot.
Fantastic. Yeah. And the fun fact you had
fun
for us.
Fact. Probably a fact that the Elliot Hotel is walking distance from here, and it's the best pub in South Australia, and they're a major sponsor.
Well, we better head there after the game for
beer. Definitely.
Yeah? We might do that. What is it about the Breakers that makes it such a great place for your players, supporters, members?
Oh, look, it's just a really, really fun, friendly atmosphere. And we all just love the game. Get out there to have a kick and enjoy it. And that's what it's all about in amateurs.
Absolutely. And your goals for this season and also longer term?
Well, obviously, finish as high as we can, go on a decent cup run.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully get promotion.
Absolutely. And finally, we're here for a cup game of footy today. Great day for it. How do you expect it's going to go, and what will be your score prediction?
Oh, look, I think Angle Vale are going to be a good side. Definitely. I think it'll be a close game, but I'm pretty confident. I think we'll probably take the win. Maybe, I don't know, 3-1.
3-1. There it is. You heard it first here.
Yeah.
Betting, if anyone gets it wrong on your bet, then we'll give a refund, will we?
Yeah, no worries, mate. No problem.
Just kidding. We'll edit that out. Thanks very much, Josh. Appreciate it, and have a great day. Cheers,
thanks,
mate.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I'm here with Aidan Oliver, who is the first team coach, well, for the Div 3 side anyway, at Angle Vale, and also a life member. Aidan, thanks for having a bit of a chat with us today. And also, how's the feeling amongst the group after a slightly longer than normal trip down to Port Elliot today?
Yeah, no worries. Thanks for having me on. Now, we're all super excited. It's not often you get to venture down this part of the world, so it's not super exciting. We don't mind a long drive, and the boys are ready to go.
Fantastic. And the history of the club, mate, can you tell us a little bit about when it was founded and what's happened leading up to a point where the club's really getting noticed around, doing great things in Sunday Div 1? So what's led you to that?
Yeah, look, started in 1989, I think predominantly we're a junior club, and then early 2000s is when the seniors sort of come to the scene. I think a few dads of the parents there. Recent times, I struggled a little bit, went all the way up to Div 2, didn't quite go as planned, and then a double relegation. 2019 was my first year in seniors, and we managed to get promoted from Div 4, and we've just been on an upward trajectory from there, and it's really exciting.
Fantastic. And what are the goals for the club for this season and also longer term?
Yeah, so we've got two first teams at the moment, Div 1 and Div 3. Obviously, there's a discrepancy in terms of Div 1 and Div 3, but I think both sides just have the same goal, cement themselves in their current division and look forward to next year. It's all about gaining traction to the club and building the community. As everyone knows, Angerville is a fast-growing community, so we just want to contribute as much as we can to that.
Fantastic. And what makes Angerville such a great place for your players, supporters, members?
I mean, I could go into the cliche of every club and say it's about the culture and the family, but to be honest, it really is. We're a club that's just built on and thrives on love. I mean, everyone really shares around the family values, and there's just so much love at the club, and it's just couldn't ask for a better place to play football, coach, and just be a part of it. It's really special.
Awesome. That's fantastic, mate. And finally, we're here today for a cup match, round two of the Challenge Cup. What do you think's going to happen out on the pitch today, and can you give us a score prediction as well?
Yeah, to be honest, we view the cup games just as an extra chance to practice our craft and work towards what we want to achieve at the end of the year. So the results aren't always the top of our minds. If you lose, you get a week off. If you win, you keep going and you get a chance to play different teams. So I would love to get a win today. I'm hoping we get up. But obviously, my prediction will be 3-1 our way. You've got to back your boys in.
Absolutely.
But Southern Breakers are a great team, and I know the guys played them last year, and they're always a good team to come up against. Good culture, good bunch of lads, so really looking forward to it.
Yeah, brilliant. Thanks, mate. Well, all the best out there today. Thanks for speaking to us, and let's enjoy a great day of football.
Appreciate it.
Cheers, mate. Good on you.